Let my revenge begin.
Welcome to Warbrick and Coon's Reviews. I'm your host, Warbrick and Coon, and today we are looking at some Mandalorian goodness. I decided to show all these off at once so we can get one review and get close towards that end of the year badassness. Let's start with the Incinerator Trooper. This guy debuted in the Mandalorian show, which is amazing, by the way. If you have not seen it by now, it's just a good show. I don't really necessarily like the way he holds the weapon. I wish it would give him a wider grip, but the figure itself is nice. I think it's on that standard trooper buck. I could be wrong, but it looks like the newer trooper buck. The paint apps are pretty good on it. I like the head on it. It looks like a head underneath there too, or simulates it. I like the shoulder pad here. It's nice and gritty. The jetpack looks good for the Empire. Okay. It's not strapped down. It's not strapped down at all, but that's cool. It's got like a harness on it. The weird thing is this fire. I mean, it works, but it kind of like leans down. And you'll get a good feel for it here as I put it in. There's no way this guy's going to hold this thing over time because it's going to keep drooping down. You can see that right there. It's kind of limp. Maybe we should call him the limp. Limp Biscuit Flame Trooper. But I like this guy. I like this guy a lot. I think I said his name right. Yep, just Googled it. Incinerator Trooper. So, not Flame Trooper, Incinerator. So, he looks good. Overall, with effects and just how he's going to look on the shelf, he's going to look dope. Because look at that chrome you got right there. And in real life, I said real life, in person, it's really shiny. I'm trying to open these blinds up more. Nope, that does not help. It's really shiny. Like really shiny. It's like chrome. So I do like that. But all in all, if I had to give this figure a rating, I'd give him a solid 8.2 or something like that. 8.2, 8.3. He is my favorite trooper I have. Even though his gun does not help that very nice. It's nice. But he was a bang up job on the show. And I think overall he's nice. Okay. Moving along, we have Ashoka. And I think this is the Rebels. Nope, this is not the Rebels Ahsoka. Yeah, it is. I think it's the Rebels Ahsoka. You know what? Let me look that up before I start lying. I can see it in the comments now. Worldbreaker Cool, get your facts right before you start reviewing. But I was right. This was Ahsoka's Tano from Rebels. And this is another one that I think has done a bang-up job. And I think this is the same look she had in the show. If you're not caught up on Mandalorian, I'm sorry, but come on by now, you gotta start watching this show. It is stupendous. I love her weapons. I love the colors. I love the face. I almost got the Ahsoka from the Clone Wars TV show instead, but there's something about this one that I just like more. Unfortunately for me, I just like the colors, the suit, and the face better. I love how she can put her lightsabers on her hip. It looked good there. I wonder if they're going to update her face to look more like Rosario Dawson. Because she's the actress playing her now. So I have a feeling they're going to do this again and change the face. But I prefer this face, to be honest. Rosario Dawson is beautiful. But I can't unsee that it's Rosario Dawson now. I like this one better. Okay. And I say that now. Watch me later on, a year from now. Oh, I love this one. Much better. Much better. So, yeah, if I had to give her a score out of 10, I would give her probably a... Gosh, she doesn't have much articulation, though, in her knee. That's kind of rough. But I'd have to give her another solid 8. I mean, she's got nice range of motion. Besides her knees, I feel a little bit wonky, but it's decent. It will do what I wanted it to do. And that's all I needed to do. So, we'll put her back here. We're getting closer to Mando. Now we have the heavy infantry Mandalorian, or infantry Mandalorian. This guy was awesome in the show. even from that first point where he almost got in a fight with Mando, I was like, I like this guy. Because he just looks like a complete badass. Look at that gritty backpack. There's lots of dirt apps on there. The skirt. I mean, he's got decent articulation for a guy this big. Ouch. Pinched myself. But, man, is that stiff. I might have to heat this guy up before I break something. But you hurt that. I mean, he's stiff, but boy, does he look nice. I mean, nice range of movement on the head. The arms. I'm not going to get to the arms because I'm just going to keep him in the same pose. I'm not really going to do much else with this guy except make him look cool on the shelf. That's about all I can do. He doesn't have any other accessories. This is it for him, but really, does he need more? When you got a gun this big, do you need more? I'd say no. I don't know if he's really... Should he have been a $30 figure, though? I don't think so. I kind of don't agree with the price tag. I think they could have fit him in at the normal price. I mean, he's a bit bigger, but he's not $30 bigger. Okay? Now, but last but not least, this is the Gorgru, or the child from the single pack. I know there's a combined pack, but I ain't paying for another one. I already bought this guy, and I had pre-ordered him, so I was not about to spend some more money. Sorry, it's Black Series, but you're not getting me. Not like that. He came with the frog, the cup, and the steering pedal, I guess. They're nice. I'm not going to take them out because I'm going to lose them. Once the moment I take these out, I'm going to lose them. But they're decent. Nothing to write home about. I don't know why you'd even want these, except for because he can't hold the bow or the gear shifter. Frog, I guess. I don't know. It's nice that he comes with it, but is this worth $10? Yes, it is. You see how cute that is? I'm kidding. I would pay this. I did pay $10 for this, though, so don't judge me. So he's awesome, and his feet are also articulated. So there's that. So I do dig it. Now, lastly, the man, the myth, the legend. That is Mando. He's got his rifle, which I like. I just wish they didn't I mean, I know why they put this peg in there, but I almost wish they didn't have it because it's not like you're going to put it on his back. See what I mean? I mean, I guess you could put it there, but then the cape's kind of like all off on the side, so it doesn't really fit. I need a cloth cape. So I'm going to look online, get some cool cloth capes, but that does not work. Can you do it on the other side? Yeah, I guess you could do it over here, but it's probably going to be the same thing. Yep, same thing. So it's not like you're going to do it that way, so I don't really dig that. And he holds it fine. He holds it fine. See, you know, he's carrying it around. And you can put his finger in the trigger, but I don't really feel like doing all that. Okay, try to keep it chill. Today's a chill review. And no, I didn't. I'm not trying to steal that from T-Man. So, I likes his articulation's about the same what you would think for a Black Series figure. I like the Beskar armor color, and this is the Beskar armor version. The original version I knew I wasn't going to get because I saw this version. I was like, oh yeah, that color is going to come out eventually. He has his pistol that he can put in his holster. It fits in there nicely. There's something missing about it. I wish it was like I don't remember this dirty part here on the show. I wish this was all silver or all Beskar armor color. The jetpack does fit on there really very nicely, but it suffers the same issue with this cape being plastic. Even though you put it on, it's not going to really work. You know what I mean? Like, this really should have been a cloth cape. Like, charge a little extra money. This could have been a good $30 figure if you added some more, you know, parts to it and made a cape that was fabric. That would have been perfect. But as it is, it's still probably my favorite Star Wars figure just because Mando is quickly becoming one of my favorite, if not favorite, characters in the Star Wars universe. He still has to get past Darth Maul right now, and Admiral Thrawn, Grand Admiral Thrawn, maybe Vader and Ren. Okay, I like a lot of the Sith and Revan, but I don't know. I'm done talking. That's it. Thank you for watching, and until next time, remember, this is the way.